sleeping on the ladies, y'all. Got it. Shut it down. Look. Look. Never hard for me since 12 years old. MCing's been a part of me. Said it's my lifeline, flowing through my arteries. So these dudes don't wanna spar with me. I don't hold back. Who you know, killer dude on his own track. Smile with him in a flick like Holak. Yo, I'm so powerful and I own that. Son, I told you where my home at. I'm from where legends are born. My history I record. Started out on the block and now I travel abroad. Yo, the difference between a mystery and fraud. Keep on guessing, but I never ever be a fake broad. I can only be me, that's real and authentic. Stepped on the scene, was mean and raw with it. Yo, truthfully, I was born with it. Took a little while to get on with it, but now I'm all in.
They said a lady can't do it like what? They said a lady can't do it like who? Yo, 100 grand say I'm better than you. Yo, 100 grand say I'm better than you. Run it back, D.Y. can't do it like what? They say the queen can't do it like who? Yo, 100 grand say I'm better than you. 100 grand say I'm better than you. Queen.
Yeah, boy, the technique sweet, I let the facts speak. Recline back to the back seat, the trunk beat. Eloquent etiquette, I'm a wild seed clarinet that wears white horse and chariot. Yo, let them cherry pick, that benefit is a prominent feminine headline ahead time. I speak fluent sun signs, yo son, I'm Sun Tzu when it's game time. I'm well versed, slick in the mix, rich mix of an alchemist, love catalyst with four challenges, real vision, realism, ambition, all in repetition, create new traditions with art and nonfiction, like I'm whipping work in the kitchen. Spitting red form, embody the unknown, and it feels so right to summon the damn horn.
They say a lady can't do it like what? They say a lady can't do it like who? 100 grand say I'm better than you. 100 grand say I'm better than you. The D.Y. can't do it like what? They say the queen can't do it like who? 100 grand say I'm better than you. 100 grand say I'm better than you.
I'm turning the page.
Quit all that cap and you never outside.
Where the fuck have you been?
Got me inside and she down for the ride.
Down for whatever, we going outside.
Live every day like it's summertime. We big lit when the money fine. Got one life, gotta live it. Mom dudes thinking I'm sinning. You follow dreams, you stay asleep. Wear a mask, you think you bring. I used to think about it every day and then it came to me.
I wanna be rich, you wanna get money.
Can't give a fuck what a nigga gon' say. I gotta be transparent like Caitlyn's dad. Wayne had gotta keep the metal in the booth. In case I gotta bless a nigga like an atchoo. Baka, 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 how I'm like a nigga baka. But I rose in New York like Derek Jeter with the deuces.
Where the nuisance go?
Can't hang with y'all niggas like nuisance. And y'all niggas don't know. If you don't water, that seed won't grow. Now I gotta figure my friends from my foes, bitch.
Quit all that cap and you never outside.
Hit me and look and I bought me a ride.
Got me inside and she down for the ride.
Down for whatever, we going outside.
Live every day like it's summertime. We big lit when the money fine. Got one life, gotta live it. Mom dudes thinking I'm sinning.
Come alive, look alive. Don't kill my vibe. Yeah.
Every time I ride through the city, little mama say she wanna roll, roll. Spend my time getting litty, man, a nigga ball out of control, control. Seen a lot of dimes, but damn, you fine, I ain't lying, nah. Just keep in mind, don't waste my time, shit, I hope you know. I ain't nothing like them, so you can't treat a nigga like him, girl, I hope you know. What I got real big, when I pull it out, look like a limb, and I hope you know. Don't play no game, pray to God, better stay in your lane, and I hope you know. That it ain't no thing, no drum line, but it go bang, and I hope you know.
Diamonds made me look like I'm hanging out with the jeweler, bitch. Came a long way from banging, hanging out with hooligans. Now I'm taking flights to different countries, about to move again. All just to jump inside a pool again, Lord. Yeah, they scream my name, I did my thing, and they applaud. All about the cash, fuck an ass and abroad. You know I'm on my grind, them niggas want me to die, and I'm that nigga that just won't stay quiet. I'm running with them niggas that nobody can question. Running with them niggas that nobody can mess with. Scooter ain't text at your neck. If a nigga got a problem, fat boy, take a test. And I don't even speak on fake friends who hate in. Find out them pussy niggas foul like flagrants. Made me get you called, get you sprayed like fragrance. I am King Clem, I'm not the nigga to play with. Now, hope you know.
Every time I ride through the city, little mama say she wanna roll, roll. Spend my time getting litty, man, a nigga ball out of control, control. Seen a lot of dimes, but damn, you fine, I ain't lying, nah. Just keep in mind, don't waste my time. Shit, I hope you know. I ain't nothing like them, so you can't treat a nigga like him, girl, I hope you know. What I got real big, when I put it out, look like a limb, and I hope you know. Don't play no game, pray to God, better stay in your lane, and I hope you know.
How the money make niggas sever their ties. Hope you niggas die sleeping in your bed of lies. I came from nothing, just hoping for better lives. So the black kings know me for the pressure I apply. Black queens know me cause I'm fresher than they got. Riding around the city, I'm that nigga with the vibe. Top down in the lack, with the jazz in the back. Having deep conversations, fill a head up with facts. I'm king, far from average. Cars is lavish, hard is savage. Bars is classic, bitch, I'm me. Boss and master talking backwards. Cause reaction, losses after, ooh. Y'all better fall back with all that nonsense. Though my niggas woke, we react without a conscience. You know what we tote, but we float with the monsters. And hang your coat like it's laundry, I hope you know.
Every time I ride through the city, little mama say she wanna roll, roll. Spend my time getting litty, man, a nigga ball out of control, control. Seen a lot of dimes, but damn, you fine, I ain't lying, nah. Just keep in mind, don't waste my time. Shit, I hope you know. I ain't nothing like them, so you can't treat a nigga like him. Girl, I hope you know. What I got real big, when I pull it out, look like a limb, and I hope you know. Don't play no game, pray to God, better stay in your lane, and I hope you know. That it ain't no thing, no drum line, but it go bang, and I hope you know.
Y'all. Full capital L, we here. We here, we doing the review stream this evening. It is happening. We're doing this Haunting in Venice, or A Haunting in Venice. Let me get that right. Yeah, shit, what up to Zuma? Appreciate you, brother. Appreciate you tuning in, man. So, as always, for the review streams, we've got a bunch of trailers that we're going to get into. And then we're, we're going to do the damn thing. Then we got some gaming after. Let me go ahead and put the Cuzzo's tracks on. Shout out to Track Justice. Get that ready. But yeah, whoops, that's not it. All right, where is it at? So we're going to jump right into these trailers. I got a few lined up. First one is called Self-Reliance. I saw my boo, Anna Kendrick's in this, apparently. So that was it for me. I was like, I'm going to watch this trailer. So we're going to do that first. It's raised up, yeah.
Hi. Are you the actor Andy Samberg?
I am.
I'm a big fan, man.
Thank you very much. Hey, I got a question for you. You want to get in?
What the hell?
Thomas Walcott, single, no children, no dependents. Job is network management, physically fit. Guess they're not too strict about that one. I'm joking. Kind of serious, though.
You have been selected to partake in the biggest reality show in the dark web.
There Interesting.
People trying to kill you, the hunters.
What are you talking about? There's people trying to murder me?
Oh, shit. You will have 30 days to survive. You will only be killed when you are alone.
So let me get this straight. You cannot touch me if I'm with someone, and then I get $1 million.
What are you doing, man? Why'd you leave my side?
I had to take a shit.
Why did you leave me? I haven't ridden me with you.
Because I'm taking a shit.
Let's play.
What the fuck is this?
This is James, my new friend.
He paid me to shadow him.
You cannot have this person sleeping in mom's house.
Are you gonna shadow me?
No.
Are you gonna shadow me?
No. Shit.
Are you gonna shadow me?
I don't wanna take away James's job.
This is gonna end badly.
Aren't there other people playing the game who could hang out with you?
Just say it.
Yes!
No, I'm not gonna.
We gotta win.
Are you gonna murder me?
No, I wanna be on the same team as you.
You want to spend all our time together after knowing me for 5 minutes?
Let's fucking win together.
Yes.
They can't kill us if we're together, right?
Stop.
Okay. Good night. I hope no one murders either of you.
Wait up. You are not as safe as you think you are.
What the fuck?
I guess. I guess I did it because I want to be around people more.
I think we did it for the same reason.
I don't want to burst your
back. Hey, Gator!
How is it a comedy? They're trying to fucking kill us.
Yo, that's what's up. Oh, Christopher Lloyd!
You been having fun?
Did you just ask if I was having fun?
Yes?
No!
Alright, well, that's gonna go on the wheel. I mean, it's gonna be on Hulu, so. Alright, not bad. This one, honestly, I saw Donald Glover, I was like, that's my dog. I don't know if this is like a reboot of Mr. and Mrs. Smith, but.
So, this is your first time in New York?
Should we be asking each other that? Have you ever killed anyone?
No. Not really.
Really?
No.
Where do I begin to tell the story of how great love can be?
You're married.
The sweet love story that is older than the sea.
I should be clear, I'm not in this for the romance.
About the love he brings to me.
What is it that you two do?
We're computer, software and engineers.
He fills my heart with very special things, with angel songs, with wild imagination.
I should be dead.
He fills my soul with so much love that anywhere I go.
How's the intimacy between the two of you?
With him alone,
I'm scared.
You could be lonely.
Oh, the Jesus. Man, we got some big names in there.
What do you think happens if we fail?
Our marriage?
Our mission.
And he'll be.
I'm still not sure what if this is like, what, a reboot of Mr. and Mrs. Smith? Is this like. Oh, it's a series. Ah. All right, Prime. I see you. All right, they dug in the crates for this one.
I almost admire you.
Yep.
Still on these streets. Running and cutting. I'm just amazed. Doesn't get to you.
I really hope this gives Eddie Murphy a dub. He needs one. Damn, dude. Look at him.
Watch your ass out there, okay?
I'm gonna be fine. They love me in Beverly Hills.
Detective Foley, you ever read your own file?
Hey!
Disturb the peace. A lot.
Please tell me you didn't get arrested again.
Twice, but I broke out.
We put our lives on the line. every day.
And for what?
Comes with the job if you're doing it right.
Yeah, babe!
Axel.
So how many people have you pissed off so far?
I haven't pissed off anybody.
Yeah,
50-50.
Is it that high?
So far.
Wow.
Okay. Okay. Yeah, man, I agree. He needs a dub, man, because he's only put out a few movies in the last few years, and they've all been stankers, apparently. So I'm hoping that's a dub. And everybody's favorite panda's back.
It is time to take the next step on your journey.
I'm not going to be the dragon warrior anymore.
You will advance to spiritual leader of the Valley of Peace.
Inner peace. Inner peace.
Keep your surf off my turf!
Dinner, please. Dinner with peas in a sesame soy glaze.
This is not working at all.
Oh, wow.
Tai Lung, big fan.
He's that, like, the second one, right?
Once I possess the kung fu of every master villain, no one will dare question my power.
Not even the great dragon warrior.
Who's that?
The most powerful shape-shifting sorceress, the chameleon.
How do I find this, the chameleon?
I'm gonna lead you right to her front door.
Yeah! It was against an army.
Then we'll just have to get an army of our own.
What is this place?
The best crooks and criminals live here.
You're a wanted criminal?
You sound surprised. Is it surprising?
Now you kids be careful of those fireworks.
Silence makes our tummies tingle.
What the fuck?
Can we help you? We can take down the chameleon together. Being the dragon warrior, it's who I am. Skadoosh. What do I know about being a spiritual leader?
What is it you're holding?
A cookie?
You were chosen to become something more than you already are.
How should we do this? Quick and painless?
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Or slow and painful?
Slow and painful.
You finally met your match, Chameleon.
We're not so different, you and I.
Stand back. I'm gonna kick my butt.
Wow. Okay. I've only seen like the first one, so. Good old fart jokes. Can't hate on that. All right, but that's that. Jenna Ortega and Martin Freeman. Mainly Martin Freeman. That's the homie.
What's your name?
Cairo Sweet.
I'm Mr. Miller. I'm assuming that you got one of these before.
I read the whole list.
Well, there's 12 books on that list.
Barty Hart.
Oh. Where's this going?
What is an adult? I'm 18. Languishing in the wilds of nowhere, Tennessee.
Don't you get scared walking through those woods?
I'm the scariest thing in there.
Oh.
I want you to write a short story in the style of your favorite author.
Are you offering me special treatment, Mr. Miller?
Well, John here is prepping her to be his transcendent.
Is she pretty?
Oh, she's talented.
Damn, even worse.
No.
What are you writing about? I'm uninspired.
I've had no achievement. Make him love you. I'll set fire to the whole
place.
She'd open her mouth to say something. But the words fell away.
Why did you write this? This is inappropriate.
Write what you know is what you say.
If you don't rewrite this, I'll have to fail you.
I dare you.
Oh! Right? Cigarettes are bad.
It's like he's been living in grayscale and you're the first thing he's ever seen in color.
You are the adult. Show some responsibility.
You're my student, and I'm your teacher. That's all.
If she can convince them that something happened between us, I could lose my job.
It's not all you could lose.
You're gonna ruin his life.
In your own words, how did it start?
Oh, boy. That's probably going to be a fucking movie. There are complex themes. Hold up. Can we pull that back up real quick? Hold up. Can we? No. Go back. I want to read that. Pause it. Damn it. There are complex themes that appear in this film. The access to access resources on some of the subject matter. See what they're doing there. All right. Honestly, I saw Steve Carell more so than I heard about Ryan Reynolds. So, but here we are.
Hi.
Well, looky.
She is the perfect.
Hey, that is Steve Carell.
Did she even see you?
She was about to.
What are you doing? Don't do this.
Oh, God.
Oh, John Krasinski.
This is just so exciting.
What is happening?
Well, that's a perfectly understandable question given numb.
I'm an if. Get it? Imaginary friend. Our kids grew up.
So we need new ones.
You could save all of us.
All of whom? And don't say ifs.
Let him say it, or I think his head may actually explode.
Yo.
Thank you.
Are you ready for this? It's like a seal by the flames tonight. There's no telling who's behind that door today.
We have to help them.
Yes, we do.
It's like Foster's Home for Imaginary Friends.
Ask you again, put some pants on, you're freaking everyone out.
Oh, John Krasinski's in it too. And we got some names. Jesus Christ!
Starting to see why I live alone.
Gee! Kind of a kid creates an invisible if.
Don't look him in the eye.
Which one?
You know damn well which one.
Thanks for doing this. It really means a whole lot.
All right, that was good. They got me. They got me there. That was good. Yeah, I agree, man. That actually looks like a wholesome movie. I honestly, it's the title that got me.
To the American Society of Magical Negroes.
Yup. I'm assuming this is a book turned into a movie, right? Or is this just a movie? I don't know.
I know you can feel their discomfort, Aaron. Watching you walk through a room full of white people was the most painful thing I've ever seen.
Excuse me. Sorry.
I don't want to take you to a job interview.
There's a recruiting class starting right now, and we got to get you in it.
Welcome to the American Society of Magical Negroes.
Is this like Harry Potter?
I don't really understand.
It's easier said. What's the most dangerous animal on the planet?
Shark.
White people, when they feel white people feeling uncomfortable precedes a lot of bad stuff for us. That's why we fight white discomfort every day. Because the happier they are, the safer we are.
The name needs a little updating, maybe like magical black people, or I guess that doesn't have the same ring.
You ready?
Oh, wow.
Your first client is a Jason Munt. His morale is far too low.
Hey.
Darn it. I was hoping there was a station right next to him.
Oh, is this one spoken for?
No.
Yeah, it's actually fun and weirdly relaxing. It's like being a secret agent with none of the danger.
Hey, I'm Lizzie.
Nice to meet you. She's great.
Yeah, she's cool.
You kidding? Come on, man. She's smart and funny. And
I know what you were doing going on about her. You're trying to set us up.
No, yeah, they are, bro. They're going to lose it.
You cannot have a relationship with Lizzie now, because if you don't put Jason first, everyone's magic will fail.
I've always felt like it's my job to make white people feel comfortable, and here it literally is. But maybe it shouldn't be.
I got a great plan to ask her out, but I'm gonna need your help.
Do you think you could, like, work your magic?
Hey, is he talking about me?
Hey.
Oh my, wait, are you? But I've traveled a long way.
Someone defied the society.
Who was it?
You didn't let her go like I told you. If you interfere with her or your client, you could have your memory erased. You won't even remember she existed.
Even though we might never see each other again, I need you to know that what we had was real.
I'm curious to see how you're gonna make it out of all this.
Well, that's a lot too much in one trailer. But yeah, man, there are gonna be some upset folks. We got one more movie trailer, and then we got a couple of game ones. A24 rule. Every time A24 drops something, we watch it or check out the trailer. Western forces as well as
the Florida Alliance. The three-term president assures the uprising will be dealt with swiftly.
Let me know if you want to try anything on.
Are you guys aware there's like a pretty huge civil war going on all across America?
We just try to stay out. With what we see on the news, seems like it's for the best.
Oh boy. Right?
Citizens of America, the so-called Western forces of Texas and California have suffered a very great defeat at the hands of the United States military.
Mr. President, do you regret the use of airstrikes against American citizens?
Damn.
We're moving to D.C. today.
We need to go down there.
They shoot journalists on sight in the Capitol. Every instinct in me says this is death.
Blood it.
Every time I survived a war zone, I thought I was sending a warning home. Don't do this. But here we are.
There's some kind of misunderstanding here. What? Well, you're American, okay?
Okay. What kind of American are you?
Ah.
You don't know?
The Western forces will reach the White House on July 4th.
Oh my God.
Get in the car! Get in the car!
Well, this is a little too real.
You're gonna hang back.
I'm not hanging back.
One nation under God. Indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Go, 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 go!
God bless America.
Yo, Kristen Dunst, though. Welcome back, homie. Welcome back. Kind of looks pretty good. Gonna say it. This is a lot of good trailers. All right. So we got a couple of game trailers, and then we're getting into this review. I'm excited for this. Oh, yeah. This shit looks so clean.
Tremble before my power. I'll show you the horrors of hell.
Shake the earth. Yo, Budokai was that deal, you know? So I'm glad they're reviving it. Sparking Zero. Why couldn't they just call it like Budokai Zero or Sparking Budokai? Like, Ah, that looks so good, though. All right, we got Light No Fires next. Shout out to Hello Games, the creators of No Man's Sky. A procedural Earth. An unexplored Earth. All footage in-game multiplayer. Don't do it again, Sean. Don't overpromise, man. You can be plenty people, apparently. Ride a hummingbird? And dragons? Sold. This looks wild. Is this Rocket League? Appreciate you spinning in, brother. So yeah, this. I'm really hoping Sean doesn't screw the pooch on this. This looks really, really good. Yeah, man. No, this is Turkey. Krusty Krab. No, this is Patrick, alright? I kind of hope it ties into, like, No Man's Sky somehow. Like, this is, like, you know, one of the original planets. I don't know, man. It looks great, though. We got bunny peoples and all sorts of shit. So, definitely wishlisted already on Steam. This also brings a big smile to my heart today, because Prime is just weird, bro. Shout out to Sega. Sega's like, yo, remember us? Remember what we used to do? Guess what? They coming back, y'all.
Did you save the game?
Really? Of course I did.
They ain't making consoles still, but hey. We got some strong IPs getting revived. Let me reintroduce you. Yes, yes. Jet Set, yes, ladies and gentlemen. That's new. Oh, what's that? Final Fight? Yup. Shinobi, yup. Shinobi looks stupid. Golden Axe looks great. Crazy Taxi. Yo, Sega about to rank in bank. Streets of Rage, that's what it was, not Final Fight. But yeah. Shout out to Sega. Yeah, exactly. Sega! Exactly. Oh, you know what? I'm going to have to include this one real quick. Sorry. So we're added one last, second to last trailer. This is me all day. I'm insanely excited for this one as well. Yes, Streets of Rage. Yep. But this right here? Mana fan from back in the Super Nintendo days, man. Yes. I will always be a fan of Mana. Thank you, Square. I appreciate you bringing me another one. This one looks even more open world. Potentially multiplayer? I don't know. a lot of the Manas are. They brought back the Mantis boss. That's what's up. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Visions of Mana. Big happy. And that comes out next year. I'm there. Sold. All right, last trailer. Shout out to Chuck.
I have a feeling this isn't over yet.
Put this one in the chat for me. In the group chat. Looks good. I like the whole idea. They're like, what if we did a style of like this, you know, in first person? I'm with it. I'm with it. Dude was like, we saw how well Cuphead did, so let's do that. You know, but let's do first person. So I respect it. All right. Those are all the trailers for the evening. We got one more, but that's for the movie we're about to review here. A Haunting. In Venice. We're going to pop that trailer up. And we're going to get into the review.
Hercule Poirot, I've found something. I've looked at it from every which way. I am the smartest person I ever met, and I can't figure it out, so I came to the second.
You are up to something, my friend.
I've seen a million of these so-called psychics, each one a fake.
I do not believe in psychics.
Come with me to a seance. Spot the con I can't.
Detective, you are here to discredit me, but I can talk to the dead.
I'd give all I have to hear my daughter's voice.
If someone wants to be heard, we are here. Listening.
Mom? Felicia? What is happening?
Drop us here. Somebody is dead. No one shall leave this place until I know who did it.
A ghost killed her.
There must be a rational answer for all of this.
Just admit that you are up against something bigger than you.
No!
Interesting. Okay.
Something in this house tried to kill me.
Don't look at me like I'm suspect. We're old friends.
Every murderer is somebody's old friend. No one shall leave until I find if the living have been killed by the dead. You have been hiding here all this time.
Who are you talking to?
Okay, you know what? This trailer. All right, let's get right into this. So this trailer definitely set a, honestly, I believe, somewhat entirely different tone of a movie than it was. So if anybody is new here, just so you know, there is a reason we tag spoilers, because we do get into some spoilers. For this one, the only thing I won't do is spoil the whodunit. I'm just going to leave that, because I think that would be fair. But overall, first and foremost, solid movie. Solid movie. The trailer, it's funny because it gives you a different vibe entirely, like it's a horror flick, when in actuality, It's more of a mystery film than it is a horror movie. There are elements of horror, for sure. Like, they definitely have, as you saw, some creepiness going on there. But it's not a horror movie at all, like, in the slightest. So, basically, the main guy here, the detective, he's just invited to this party. It's going to have a seance by Miss Tina Fey. And shout out to her. Because she thinks the medium, Michelle Yeoh, is legit. And him being the detective he is, and so world-renowned, and bases everything off of reality, facts, and all that jazz. She's like, I want him to, you know, see this and see if this is legit. And they show that in the trailer, obviously. You know, and that's just, you know, that's how it starts. Pretty straightforward and simple. But then, you know, once you get into it, it starts getting a little pretty crazy. You know, they kind of toe that line, thinking it's going to be horror. But at the end of the day, it's just a classic mystery film where you're trying to figure out, you know, who killed the owner of the house's daughter. Because during said seance, they contact her. And she's like, I was murdered. Not in those exact words, but basically, yes. One thing I will say, they kind of sold this on Michelle Yeoh. Like they sold the vampire movie with Aaliyah. I can't think of the name right now. Oh, Queen of the Damned. They sold that based off of Aaliyah. And it's kind of the same situation where they both were not in the film that long. But even the short time that Michelle Yeoh's in there, she kills it. I mean, she is who she is. She's an amazing actress. And yeah, she does a great job. I like the scene where they do the seance. It was very jarring to an extent at a certain point of it. But overall, you know, it's definitely really well done. A lot of the shots they use in regards to, like, you know, the camera work and everything, a little weird at times, honestly. I think they were trying to, like, go for the creepy vibe. And, you know, I don't know if it was a case, like, it seemed like a case where they wrote it one way and then they filmed it in a different way. Like the trailer kind of puts out there. Like, it's supposed to be a scary movie or almost a horror with some mystery elements, where it's vice versa. It's a mystery movie with some horror elements. But, you know, it's not bad at all. Like, it's really good. I was actually really impressed with it. The whole cast was great. The only one I was kind of annoyed with, so you have the owner of the house who wanted to have the seance to talk to her daughter. There's also a doctor who's there with his son, and his son is a super smart kid. Kind of annoying, honestly. But, you know, overall, it's a good time. I was honestly really impressed by Tina Fey as well. I haven't seen her in much besides the few comedies that I've seen her in. So it was kind of refreshing to see her outside of a comedic role. But yeah, it rolls very well. It's a tight, hour and 44 minutes, 103 minutes, total. So it's very tight. No, wasted time on screen, no wasted scenes. There was not one point where I was sitting there like, what the hell? Like, it works really, really well. The score's there, everything about it works. Even with the final reveal of who the killer is or murderer, there is a caveat that I do want to mention. So, the kid plays a more important part than you think. I was going to say that much, and I'll give him that. It was very clever. It was very, very clever how they did it. And they used this child. But the main guy here, the detective, what is his name? Kenneth Branagh. I guess that's his name. He kills it. I like this character. Also, the way he explains things. Because if you've seen mystery films, especially like Knives Out, if you've seen Knives Out, very similar to that, where, you know, at the end he's breaking it all down and, you know, explains how he came to his conclusions, and they kind of have you at a moment before the end. They kind of almost hit you with, oh, it's these individuals, but it's not. So I give him mad props to that. Otherwise, there's a lot of good moments in this movie. I definitely recommend it. I honestly kind of wish I would have did this during Halloween, because the movie takes place on Halloween evening. So it's a very fitting movie in that respect. But yeah, I mean, honestly, I felt like I was watching a Knives Out movie. Not even gonna lie. But if it was, you know, had a little bit of that, you know, horror aspect to it. I guess horror is the best term to use. But it's not a horror movie. I just want to be very clear that the trailer makes it seem like it's about ghosts. Hey, shout out to Bran. Appreciate you tuning in. The trailer really, really, really makes you feel like, oh, this is going to be a horror movie. It is not in the slightest whatsoever. They do make you think a little bit from here to here that it might be some supernatural powers, you know, killing people. But you obviously find out that it's not. You know, and that's the whole idea of it. And, you know, I can't really hate on it, honestly. Like, there's not really anything I didn't like besides the kid. The kid, like I said, was a little annoying, you know? but they did everything really well, especially in the opening when they're kind of setting the tone. And, you know, he goes to the Halloween party and, you know, begrudgingly, really, goes to this Halloween party. And it's in Venice, as the title indicates. And let me tell you, man, you know, I used to have this whole, like, man, you know what would be really cool? If I ever had a bunch of money and I can travel, I would like to go to, like, Australia or Japan, right? You know, Venice just shot up there after watching this. Like, it's always been on the list, right? But it shot up there, man. Like, just watching the way they show you a little bit of how it was back then. And also just the riding around the whole town, like boats and shit, man. Like, that shit seems so cool. Like, I would be about that life, you know? But yeah, it's really neat how they show some of the fact that apparently, I don't know this, and we can Google it or wiki it at some point if somebody wants to do that. Apparently, like, America introduced France, or, you know, Venice, Italy, Venice, like, they introduced them to Halloween. Like, that's a thing. I didn't know this. I didn't know this. Could be just for the movie, maybe. I would think they were trying to be, you know, correct. I would assume so. I mean, to be fair, this was loosely based on an Agatha Christie book. So I'm assuming she did her homework, you know, and they wouldn't just bring that up. But that was pretty neat. I was like, oh, I didn't know that shit. And I learned a little something watching it. But showing the kids in their costumes, yo, fuck what we do nowadays. All right, I'm just going to say it. Fuck what we do nowadays. Because them costumes, as cheap and crappy as they were, look scarier than most shit we do nowadays. I'm just saying. Like, it's crazy. But showing the kids' party, they do a little, I guess you can call it a puppet show, I guess. They throw up this big white sheet, throw a light behind it, and they do, I guess, shadow puppets would be the best way to describe it. But they use a lot of figures and, clippings and stuff to do this little puppet show, which I thought was really cool. You know, I've seen it done in movies from China and shit like that, you know, like some of the martial arts movies I likes, and they do that. And so it was neat seeing it in that way, but also like these kids had it pretty cool, regardless if they was orphans or not. They're in this creepy ass house getting to watch this cool shadow puppet thing. And then there's candy and games they're playing, and that was pretty cool, you know? Like, they knew how to party, you know what I'm saying? But, so it's a pretty good movie. I definitely recommend it. I recommend anybody who hasn't seen it to check it out if you got Hulu or Disney Plus, because Hulu is now a part of Disney Plus, so you can watch that. But again, I'm not going to spoil the actual ending at all. I normally do most reviews, but with this, since it's a whodunit, I'm going to stay away from it this time because it's really good. It's not necessarily who you expect, unless I'm just an idiot and didn't catch on to it. But also the final little cherry on top after the reveal, shots of Brother Latino Heat, so highly recommend it, definitely. Trying to think, is there anything else I want to, also I will say, shout out to the way they did the interviews in this, because, you know, every mystery movie, you interview all the suspects. It was pretty same, but just a little different enough to not be like, well, damn, I can just watch Knives Out again or Knives Out 2. Or like, it did a really good job with that. I'll definitely say that. But yeah, great movie. Again, don't go into this thinking you're going to be watching Michelle Yeoh the whole time, because they sold you on it. They're like, yo, this is her movie. It's not. I'm only saying that. So, with that being said, overall, like I said earlier, great movie, well-paced, great everything about it. Like, I can't applaud this movie enough, honestly. I'm only sad I didn't watch it sooner. So, with that said, we're going to get into the scene. It's tough, because there's a lot of great scenes in this movie. But I would have to say, for me... The seance was great, don't get me wrong, but probably, I'm going to say, when there's a moment towards the end when he's starting to kind of put two and two together, and it starts, you know, kind of getting real crazy. And they're kind of running around the house. It's really good. I can't really say too much because it'll give away the whodunit. But it's definitely pretty much towards the end when he starts putting it together, and everybody is being kind of like, you know, pointing the fingers. There's a lot of good lines there. And then as for the score... fuck it. I'm gonna give it a strong 9. Strong 9. Very strong. I can't give it anything higher than a 9 only because it is a whodunit movie, you know? Like, that's literally what you're getting. You're not getting a horror movie. You're getting a whodunit. And they want to even try to say it's a thriller, and I can't even say that. It's a mystery movie with dashes of thriller and dashes of horror. It is not just a mystery film. It's a strong mystery film, but it is very similar to plenty of that came before it, like Knives Out. Hell, even Clue. Even Clue, which was a comedy mystery. You know, and with Clue, fun fact, they had multiple endings. So you could have, you know, seen one from Brother. I wish this could have did something like that, but I don't think with the way the story is written, they could have. Or maybe they couldn't. I don't know. We'll see. I really hope for more stuff like this. I'll probably have to put the second Knives Out on the wheel on this coming Monday. Speaking of which, if you want to participate and you want to put a movie on the wheel, be here Monday night. We'll be doing the next wheel spin for the next movie review. But yeah, man, check it out. Haunting in Venice, highly recommend. Great time. And if you didn't read the whole plot while I had it on the screen, you'll be pleasantly surprised. But now, we're going to go ahead here and get into some gaming.